Hi, everyone. Thank you for tuning in tonight. I'm Ryan Murray, the Associate Conductor for the Modesto Symphony and the Music Director for our Modesto Symphony Youth Orchestra. Tonight's event is part of our virtual series, MSO at Home. The events in this series will be free to all to help provide a place where our community can reconnect and enjoy music together. We'd like to thank and acknowledge H. Dieter and Hannah Renning, who helped support tonight's program. So far in our At Home series, we featured two of our orchestra musicians, John Hillebrandt and Dan Flanagan. And this month, we're putting the spotlight on another part of the MSO family, the Modesto Symphony Youth Orchestra. Creating these virtual events has been a fun challenge for us, and tonight we wanted to highlight the MSYO as they start their new season, and we want to talk a bit about how the program has shifted towards virtual rehearsals. Tonight, I'll be joined by my fellow MSYO conductor, Don Grishaw, and we'll talk a bit about how we've reimagined the upcoming season. So tonight, we have a lot of fun and interesting music to listen to, highlighting our two youth orchestras, our chamber string group, and a few performances from the conductors, too. We also have our MSYO musicians watching at home, and I hope they enjoy the chance to hear themselves play, this time from the audience's perspective. I'm really excited to start our show tonight with a highlights reel from our concert orchestra. This clip features some performances from this past February and is a great showcase of our younger group. Most of the students in this group are between the 6th and 9th grade, and they make great musical progress with their excellent conductor, Don Grishaw. Let's have a listen. Well, I hope you really enjoyed that clip, and I'm really happy to be here with our concert orchestra conductor, Don Grishaw. In addition to conducting our concert group, Don's also a violinist in the Modesto Symphony, and this is one of the many great connections that our youth orchestra has with our professional group. Well, welcome, Don.
Well, good evening, Ryan, Modesto Symphony audience, Modesto Symphony Youth Orchestra members. I'm honored to be a part of this evening's production.
Well, thanks so much for being here. And can you tell us a bit more about our concert orchestra? What is the group like? And what are your goals in a typical year?
Sure. Well, the MSYO is unique in our county in that we offer a full orchestra. And most of the students at schools will take either band if they play wind or brass or percussion instruments, or they will take orchestra, which is really string orchestra. So we offer the full orchestra with all the different sections included. And our goal is to develop the students' ensemble skills. So we begin every rehearsal with sectionals during the first hour. And the wind students work on becoming, if it were, student soloists because they play one to a part. And they're also learning sharp keys, how to play in the sharps. The percussion family, those who are learning percussion have a chance to learn multiple instruments, maybe snare drum, bass drum, timpani, mallets, cymbals. And in the strings, they're working on their initial experiences of playing in an ensemble, and they're also learning how to play in the flat keys. My goal is to prepare the young students for the symphony orchestra, which Ryan Murray conducts.
Well, thanks, Don. And can you tell us now, how are things different this year? And maybe you can tell us a little bit about what we're doing virtually to bring music education to our community.
Yes, indeed. Everything is virtual so far this year. And beginning with the student auditions, they recorded their auditions and sent their videos to us. We're using Zoom for rehearsals, and we assign different passages for the students to prepare, and we coach them on the parts that they have worked on. We're preparing for a final concert recording down the road. And we've also prepared recordings for the students to practice with and play along with. We're also looking for additional virtual sources, which will allow the director to hear all the students play together at once. And actually, we can hear them in sync, which would be amazing.
I'm really looking forward to that, definitely. So music seems to be a big part of your family. You and your wife perform together, and both of your children play music as well. Is that right?
Yes, my wife sings, and she and I have played for Sunday masses and weddings and quinceañeras for many years together. Both my children grew up playing the piano and the violin, and they both went through the MSYO program, the concert orchestra and the symphony orchestra. My daughter's a violinist. She lives in the Bay Area, and my son, Andrew, is a violist. He lives in Los Angeles.
That's great. And so this next clip is actually you and your son, Andrew, playing. So I'm hoping you can tell us a little bit about the piece you're going to play and a little bit about Andrew. He played in the MSYO and later was a soloist with our Modesto Symphony. So what's he doing now?
Oh, okay. Andrew's currently working on his doctorate in viola performance at USC, University of Southern California. And he was selected to perform with the Modesto Symphony Orchestra 2 years ago. He performed a concerto for viola and orchestra that was actually written by our former music director, David Lockington. The piece that we selected to perform for you this evening was written by Béla Bartók, who is a 20th century Hungarian composer, who's often considered one of the first ethnomusicologists. So he actually went into the villages in his native Hungary, collecting folk songs of the people, which he later incorporated into his music in his own unique style. So this evening, you're going to hear five of the 44 duets that he originally wrote for two violins in an arrangement for two violas.
Look for
some of the use of accents, unusual rhythms, key signatures, changing meter. And I just wanted to add that live music making is definitely scarce during the pandemic. And so if you have musicians in your household, look for opportunities, look for music that you can play with whatever combination of instruments you have. And that's what Andrew and I did. And we're going to share the five duets by Béla Bartók with you.
Well, that is so great, and I'm really excited to hear it.
Mm-hmm.
Really enjoyed that, and it was great to hear the viola featured like that, with two violas with beautiful sound and beautiful connection. So thanks so much for that, Don. I know we all really enjoyed that. And now we're going to hear a performance from me playing. So like everyone during the pandemic, I've been spending more time at home, and I've been kind of yearning for this connection with musicians and with music. And so I've started practicing my own instrument a little bit more and playing along with myself at the piano or other musicians at the piano, virtually, of course. And so what you're going to hear next are the first three songs from Schumann's song cycle, Dichterliebe. Now, this is one of the kind of hallmark pieces of the Romantic period. And we see Schumann at the height of his romantic powers with these unbelievably beautiful lyric lines and this incredibly complicated piano part. And the singer, or in this case, the bassoonist, can just kind of float over the line that's created in the piano. You know, as a bassoonist, we have a limited amount of repertoire. So I'm often looking for vocal pieces or cello pieces or other things like that that I can kind of steal and make my own. And I just love playing these Schumann pieces. So I hope you enjoy the first three songs from Schumann's Dichterliebe. So I hope you enjoyed hearing that as much as I enjoyed playing it. I actually sang these pieces on my senior voice recital back in college, so it was nice to revisit them again, and I was happy to be able to share them with you. Now, Dawn talked a bit about how our rehearsals are going on Zoom, but I want to talk just for a second about our performances. So we can't perform in the same room together right now, and as you might imagine, we can't just record a Zoom meeting. If you've been on any Zoom meetings, you know as soon as more than one or two people start talking at the same time, it becomes total chaos. And so for musicians, that delay and that delay across different connections becomes a big problem. So instead, what we do, as Dawn mentioned, we make reference recordings where either Dawn or I are conducting along with a click track or along with us counting out the rhythms, and we send those to the musicians. Then the musicians record their own parts individually, send them back to us, and we digitally put them all together. And it's really a fun process, although it's quite a lengthy process. But it's pretty great to be able to hear all of our musicians together, even when they're recording in different homes. So this next performance is from last season. It's from our string chamber group. Some of these students have graduated, and some are still with us this season. And they're playing a Vivaldi concerto for two violins that's been arranged for string quartet. And none of these musicians were able to hear each other when making the recording. So I think that's pretty amazing. And I hope you enjoy this Vivaldi performance. Well, I hope you enjoyed the premiere performance of that work and that digital recording. Even the players that played in it are hearing it for the first time tonight. So I hope they enjoyed hearing it too. It was really fun to put together. So the last bit of music that we've got for you tonight features our Modesto Symphony Youth Orchestra Symphony Orchestra. See if you can say that five times quickly. And we're doing a highlights reel from our concerts last year in the winter and the early spring, February, I think it was. So we've got some Sibelius, some Dvorak, and finishing up with the amazing Gershwin American in Paris. And if you have any questions for us, feel free to put them in the chat during this piece, and we'll try to answer them at the end of the show. So I hope you enjoy this performance from our symphony orchestra.
Thank you.
Well, thank you all again for joining us tonight. It's really fun for Dawn and I to revisit some of those performances from last season, and I hope you enjoyed hearing them as well. So thank you for joining us, and thank you, Dawn, for being here with us tonight.
Well, thank you so much for your invitation. It's been my pleasure to be here this evening, and I would just like to say thank you to our Modesto Symphony and Modesto Symphony Youth Orchestra audiences for all your support for everything that we do.
Thanks, Dawn. And thank you for everything you do as well. So once again, we'd like to thank H. Dieter and Hannah Renning, whose support helped make tonight's program possible. And we'd like to thank all of our season sponsors and donors. We would not be able to have these virtual concerts for the community without all of your support. If you're interested in learning how to support the MSO and future virtual events, please visit modestosymphony.org/support. Your gift will help keep these events free to all and help keep arts alive in our community. Join us on October 21st when we'll have cellist Julian Schwartz in recital. Julian is a fabulous musician, and he's got this great program planned for us with himself and piano. It's going to be just an absolutely beautiful performance, and I'm really looking forward to getting to know Julian better and getting to share his music with all of you. Many of you may remember Julian when he performed the Boccherini Cello Concerto with the MSO back in 2014, so it'll be great to see him again. And lastly, thank you to everyone watching at home. We hope you enjoyed the program, and we'd love to hear from you. We have a very short survey that is linked in the description and will be posted in the chat. Your feedback will help us plan future events. So for now, have a great rest of your evening, stay safe, and we look forward to seeing all of you again next time. Thank you so much for joining us.